charges. A capacitor is a device that stores charges. It consists of two conductors. It consists of two conductors separated. It consists of two conductors separated by separated by a free space, separated by a free space, which you call it the dielectric. This free space, you normally call it a dielectric. Full stop. When a DC voltage is applied, between the conductors, when a PD voltage is applied between the conductors, a charge transfer occurs. A charge transfer occurs, resulting in a positive Q in one conductor, and negative Q in the other conductor. Full stop. Electric field lines, in brackets, electric field line, in brackets, flux, run from the positive conductor. Runs from the positive conductor to the negative conductor which are perpendicular to the conductor surface, in brackets, equipotential. Capacitance is equal to Q over V12, where C is the capacitance. Q is the charge. And V12 is the voltage. This is a brief introduction of the capacitance. Right, okay. So the next subheading is steps involved. In calculating the capacitance. Wacha niwe na a brief break kidogo.
Choose an appropriate coordinate system. You look at this capacitor. Is it a spherical capacitor? Is it a cylindrical capacitor? Or is it a box capacitor? So if you have that in your mind, now you'll be able to know what you are going to do in your capacitance. Choose an appropriate
coordinate system for the capacitors. To choose an appropriate coordinate system for the given geometry model. Choose an appropriate coordinate system for the given geometry. Because the capacitance can be either be cylindrical, it can be either spherical, it can be either in Cartesian form. So that is what we say, choose an appropriate coordinate system for a given geometry. Number two, assume plus Q and negative Q for the conductors. Assume plus Q and negative Q on the conductors. And then Find E from Q. Find E from Q by Gauss law. I.E. E is equal to Q over 4 pi epsilon r squared A of r. Find E by Gauss law, i.e. E is equal to Q over 4 pi epsilon r squared A of r. And then find V from the first conductor, from the second conductor to the first conductor, by V is equal to negative Q over, no, by V is equal to E minus, find V from the second conductor to the first conductor by V from, V is equal to negative integral of E dl from the second conductor to the first conductor. Number five. Find C, that is the capacitance, by the formula C is equal to Q over 1V12. By the formula Q is equal to V over C is equal to Q over V12. Any question? Any problem? Any question? Before capacitor, this is a parallel plate capacitor. This is a parallel plate capacitor. And this is the electric flux. This is plus Q and this is minus Q. This is PS plus PS. This is minus PS. This is the electric field intensity and this is A of Y. This is the distance D and this is the distance A of X.
that is the distance A of x.
Because one is in the direction of Victoria and Kwale. So let's come here, let's come up here and say, V is equal to 2 to 1 my minus EDL, which is equal to minus 2 to 1. This is the E, and E is this value here. So this is minus Q epsilon A of Y. And then we have this value, which is DL. And DL is A of Y dy dy, A of Y, because this one is supposed to go in the direction of A of Y from a fixed point to a maximum point D. So we can rewrite this one and say from 0 to D into Q over epsilon A of Y, A of Y dy, but A of Y dot A of Y is equal to 1, which will imply, which implies that V is equal to 0 to D into Q over epsilon A dy dy. So this one can be written as Q is equal to epsilon A of Y from 0 to D, which this one is Q over epsilon A of D. The lastly, now capacitance is Q over V12. So this one will be Q, and V12 is this one, which will be epsilon A over QD, cancelling the Q. This one will be epsilon A over E. And that is the formula for capacitance. Unless you have a question. Unless you have a question. Think of a question. Who number had me? This is moving in the A of Y.
Example. A parallel plate capacitor, example, a parallel plate capacitor has internal separation
D. A parallel plate capacitor has internal separation D. Has internal
separation D between the plates. Full stop. A dielectric slab
with epsilon R between the plates.
Yeah, between the plates. A dielectric slab with epsilon R
of thickness A.
Slab with ER. With ER of thickness A is placed on the lower plate, is placed on the lower plate of the capacitor. Show that the electric field intensity
in the dielectric, show that the electric field intensity in the dielectric, show that the electric field intensity in the dielectric A is E1 is equal to flux over epsilon R of D minus A into epsilon R minus 1, where floods is equal to potential difference is equal to potential difference between the plates, difference between the plates, and B, electric field intensity, electric field intensity in the airspace, is E naught is equal to epsilon r E1 and C capacitance, of the capacitor, CT. CT is epsilon naught A over D into epsilon R over 1 minus A over D epsilon R plus A over D.
Write that and then continue.
It states that dN1 is equal to dN2 and dN1 is the flux density, the normal components of the flux density. We can call this one our barrier. So this is the interface between two dielectrics. This is dielectric 1 and this is dielectric 2. So there are boundary conditions when this one is crossing this one, and we call it the normal components of flux density is 1 is equal to the normal components of flux density 2. So and D is equal to epsilon E. Quite okay. D is equal to epsilon E. So epsilon in this first one is epsilon naught, epsilon r, and then let's call this one er. Quite okay. Are we together? This is d is equal to epsilon e, and epsilon is made of these two components. So for the slab, it will be epsilon naught, epsilon r, e of r. We call this one e of r. Are we together? Yeah. So this one will be equal to epsilon naught, but okay, epsilon naught, because D is equal to epsilon E. So this one will be equal to epsilon naught, E naught. Epsilon R here is equal to 1. So that divide this one by epsilon naught, and divide this one by epsilon naught, then we know that E naught is equal to epsilon R E of R, which is your second part of answering it.
That is, I've answered that second part. Unless you have a problem, I've answered that second part.
D is epsilon E. So for this slab, epsilon epsilon E for the slab is epsilon naught, epsilon R, E, and I'm choosing this slab as E of R. Quite okay. Let's go to the airspace. The airspace is epsilon naught, epsilon R, E of E naught, being in the airspace. Quite okay. Are we together? I can cancel the epsilon naught and the epsilon naught. Quite okay. And then I remain with epsilon R, E of R is equal to epsilon R, E naught. But epsilon R of air is equal to 1. So epsilon L for this side, epsilon R for air is 1. So this can be written as epsilon R, E of R is equal to E naught. As simple as that.
Nyako. Mkubwa. Lakini kwa tulikuwa tunafuatana vizuri sana wewe. Ni mpaka pale tulipo divorce. Ukarudi kwa mzee kamili. Tulikuwa tunafuatana hata alikuwa anafurahi sana katika EFT. Hata hivi ni mbao, mbao electronics. Ulienda wewe? Ulienda kumpikia mzee samaki. Hai.
You can start with anywhere, but the best place to start with is this place for the question. So,
so you pick up an E1 instead. Pick up an E1.
E-R?
An E1 instead.
Oh, this one. Oh, you can call it E1 or I'll call it E-R. Yeah, let me call it E1. So. Let me call it E1. Instead of ER, let me call it E1. So this one is E1. So that they can match the same thing. This one is E1. So. Yeah, thank you for the question. So now you can do the next part.